pleasant good morning to all of us here. I know it could have been a better morning, but thank God we're all alive, and we live to fight many, many more days. Let me recognize the presence of my colleague ministers, permanent secretaries, disaster coordinator, members of the media. I first want to extend my greatest sadness on behalf of my family and myself and the Ministry of Housing on the tragic incident of which we all know yesterday it was. And we're very lucky, as the minister said, that there were no loss of life, because these wooden buildings have been aging for a while. And I mean, it could only take a little spark to ignite the fire. And government recognized that some time ago, because you can recall that about 2 years ago we started the reconstruction of Silver Lake, because we recognize that you have challenged as far as housing and other needs were concerned, social needs, educational needs. But so we felt that housing was a major critical area for the residents of Silver Lake. And so we began the process of constructing the apartment buildings. We've completed one over $1 million, and I heard that I know that over six families have been comfortable. There were a lot of criticism, whether they're too big or they're too small or they're too tall or they're too short. But at the end of the day, they provide a great level of comfort for the persons in there. And you don't have to pay any rent, and I mean you're comfortable with your family. We have started the second one as we promised. The money is available. The money was placed in last year's budget or 2 years ago in the budget. There is money available for the construction of that second apartment building. There has been some administrative challenges, and you would know that there has been a little slowness. But the government has done what it has to do, which is making the money available for the construction. So the administrative challenges has to be sorted out between the contractor and the ministry. But that, I understand, is well on its way. And very shortly, especially after the incident yesterday, you will see an acceleration of the progress on that second building. You also knew, and we promised you, that after that second building, we'd have moved into the third building and the fourth building. But as fate has had it, we have to move much quicker than we anticipated on the second and the third building, on the third and the fourth building. And the Prime Minister promised you yesterday that construction or work will start immediately on that other building. We have been clearing the site. We have been seeking to engage contractors. I'll be meeting with the staff of the ministry this morning. We're going to review the designs, look at the designs, and to set a definite date when we will start construction. But I can tell you, it's going to be quick, it's going to be swift. Because even if the government has to pay the rent, but you're never as comfortable in a rented home than in your own home and in your own property. Things you'd like to do at your house, you can do it in somebody else's house. And so we are promising, as we have done before, and we have kept up to our promise to take care of the residents of Silver Lake in a big way. So as Minister of Housing, I can reassure you that work will be accelerated on the existing building, and we'll start in quick time for the construction of the other buildings that were promised to the persons of Silver Lake. And this has nothing to do with the fire, it was a commitment that we made, it's a commitment that we're fulfilling, but now that this event has happened, we'll speed up on it, and we can reassure you that in as short a time as possible, you, the resident of Silver Lake, will move back to your community and to continue to do what you have to do for yourselves and your family. So be patient with us, bear with us, accept the contribution that we're making to you at this point in time, but it's only a temporary measure. And like they say, weeping may endure in the night, but joy will come in the morning. Thank you very much.